You want to get into UniFi, but you're on a budget. So then, what's the best budget bang for your buck UniFi setup here in the middle of 2025? Well, I've got a couple of options for you. Let's talk about it. Ubiquiti has a ton of options when you're picking out equipment, so it can definitely get confusing. The cheapest stuff that they sell isn't necessarily the best bang for your buck. So that's my goal for this video. Instead of just telling you the absolute cheapest gear that they offer, I'm going to show you what I would recommend to someone who wants to get into UniFi and who wants a network that's not only cost-effective, but also provides a good foundation upon which to build out more equipment in the future. Because let's face it, UniFi gear can be addictive, so it's better to get the right equipment up front so that you're not having to replace stuff down the line. Both of these options that I'm going to talk about today come in at under 400 bucks for a complete network solution. So let's start with option number one, and that is the UniFi Dream Router 7. So the Dream Router 7 comes in at 279 bucks, and it's an excellent way to dip your toes into the world of UniFi. The Dream Router 7 is an all-in-one gateway, meaning it's a firewall, you got a little four-port switch, you've got an integrated Wi-Fi 7 access point on top, and you've got UniFi OS on board. UniFi OS is the operating system that runs the various UniFi applications, such as Network, which, as you may have guessed, manages your network. But under that UniFi OS umbrella, you've also got UniFi Protect for video surveillance, you've got UniFi Access for door control, you've got UniFi Talk for voice over IP communication, and you've got UniFi Connect for IoT type devices. Not all UniFi OS gateways have the ability to run all of these apps, but the Dream Router 7 definitely does, and it even comes with a little 64 gig micro SD card for UniFi Protect surveillance footage if you want to add on a camera. Though, to be quite honest, 64 gigs is not a ton of space, nor is constantly writing to a micro SD card the best solution when it comes to using an NVR. Or in other words, while the Dream Router 7 does have UniFi Protect, and while it does have 64 gigs of micro SD storage, that's good for maybe one camera, and you really shouldn't count on that for anything super mission critical. The Dream Router 7 is a great choice for small deployments, such as your apartment or a small home. It can handle a multi-gigabit internet connection, and one of the switch ports in the back here even has power over Ethernet so that you can power up a camera, a phone, or an access point. I've always called this thing the mother-in-law router because it's a great choice for us tech guys and gals to install at our in-laws' house to get them a decent gateway that can be managed remotely through UniFi's cloud. And in fact, the next time I go visit my dad who lives in another state, I'm gonna be bringing this one with me to set up for him at his house. It's not gonna seem any different than what he has today, but I'll be able to manage it remotely when he calls me with issues. The main downside to the Dream Router 7, in my opinion, is that it is an all-in-one unit. Now, one of the benefits of stepping into the UniFi ecosystem is that you can really custom tailor your gateway, your switches, and your access points to your individual needs. So for example, if your internet service provider hands off your internet connection to like a front bedroom in your house, if you've got this Dream Router 7 installed, your access point is now stuck in that same location. You've got no ability to separate the access point from the gateway and put it somewhere else that may be better to provide wireless coverage. Or in other words, depending on the layout of your house, this might not be your best option. So now let's talk about a budget UniFi network that gives you a bit more deployment flexibility. That means we're gonna have a separate gateway, network switch, and access point that you can place in different locations around your house and then just connect them all together with Ethernet cables. Starting with the gateway here, I'm going with the UCG Ultra, or the Cloud Gateway Ultra, which costs 129 bucks. Now, the UCG Ultra can manage up to 30 UniFi devices with over 300 connected clients. It's got a 2.5 gigabit WAN port with 4 1 gigabit LAN ports. The UCG Ultra is a great starter gateway, but it does still have some limitations. So first of all, while it does have UniFi OS on board, it can only run UniFi Network. With this UCG Ultra, you don't get Protect or Access or any of the other UniFi apps. Now for some people, maybe that's no problem, but If you do think you're going to want to play around with some of the other UniFi apps in the future, you should consider starting with the Cloud Gateway Max instead. Now, it's going to increase the cost to $199 instead of $129, but you at least have the option of these other applications. Another downside of the UCG Ultra is that it's only rated for 1 gigabit of internet throughput with intrusion prevention enabled. So if you've got an internet connection that's a gigabit or more, your bandwidth is going to get bottlenecked by this gateway. And again, I would have to then recommend bumping up to the UCG Max, which has 2.3 gigabits of internet throughput. But for $129, if you've got a sub-gigabit internet connection and you're not really interested in exploring any of the other UniFi applications, you really can't beat the UCG Ultra. So let's now talk about network switches. So the UCG Ultra gateway doesn't have any PoE, or power over Ethernet. PoE is used to power up other devices through the network cable, like surveillance cameras, voice over IP phones, or access points. And since we're trying to build a strong UniFi foundation with our budget network here, we're definitely going to want some sort of device that provides PoE. And that's where the network switch comes in. So my recommendation is the Lite 8 PoE switch, and you can grab this one for $109. The Lite 8 PoE is an 8-port gigabit switch, of which 4 of the ports provide PoE plus power to your devices. Now, this is going to allow you to expand your wired network to computers, or your television, or gaming consoles, or whatever, any other wired devices that you have around, but it's also going to be able to power up an access point or multiple access points. So keep in mind that if your network doesn't have a bunch of wired devices and you want to go primarily wireless, you actually don't need this switch. You can just have a PoE injector for the access point, and then the switch becomes basically optional. So now let's talk about the access point. And there are 2 access points that I would recommend. Really depends on whether or not you want Wi-Fi 7. Now, I would go with either the U7 Lite, that's this one right here, for $99, or I would go with the U6 Plus, which is $129. Both of those access points are the entry-level access points for either Wi-Fi 6 or Wi-Fi 7. Now, the U6 Plus has a bit better performance and range than the U7 Lite. It's rated to cover 1,500 square feet or 140 square meters versus the U7 Lite, which is rated to cover 1,250 square feet or about 115 square meters. The U6 Plus can also service more client devices, 300 or so versus 200 with the U7 Lite. But honestly, realistically, when we're talking about this like budget network, it's highly unlikely that you're ever gonna come anywhere close to that many client devices connected to these access points. So then what it boils down to is whether you have Wi-Fi 7 client devices that need the extra speed provided by a Wi-Fi 7 access point, which in this case is going to be arguable because in my budget network here, the U7 Lite with its 2.5 gigabit Ethernet connection is going to be connected to a gigabit PoE switch, right? So there isn't going to be any noticeable speed difference between the U6 Plus and the U7 Lite for this network. So in my opinion, if you're on the fence about whether to get the U6 Plus or the U7 Lite, I'd pay the extra $30 and get the better range provided by the U6 Plus. It's really a solid access point. It's one that I recommend quite a bit. So totaling up my second UniFi budget build option, we've got the UCG Ultra at $129, we've got the Lite 8 PoE switch at $109, and we've got a U6 Plus at $129, which brings the grand total to $367 for what I consider to be a really solid UniFi foundation that also gives you the flexibility to place these various components where they make the most sense around your house. One more thing that I do want to cover here, there are still cheaper UniFi devices that you can buy. So for example, you could do the Express 7 for $190, which is kind of like a smaller alternative to the Dream Router 7. It's like an all-in-one unit. But in my opinion, the Express 7 is just too limited in power to be realistic for home use. Yes, these are budget builds, but my advice is the best bang for your buck. And I feel like the majority of users would benefit from my other 2 recommendations here versus something like the Express 7. Now, same goes for the access point, right? So technically, the cheapest UniFi access point is the UK Ultra at $89, but That's older generation Wi-Fi 5 technology, and it's not really powerful enough for home use. So in my opinion, the UK Ultra is more of a supplemental access point for your backyard or something like that. And remember, a ton of the older out-of-production UniFi gear can be found on eBay and Facebook Marketplace, right? And so while that gear is no longer sold by Ubiquiti, most of it is still supported in UniFi, and it should work just fine if you can snag something at a good price. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my recommendation for a home network that provides 10 gigabit connectivity to your devices. Definitely not going to be a budget build, but worth checking out. And the bottom video is my complete review of the Dream Router 7.